audience fragmentation. It's something that we measure every morning at 11 with our affiliates and at 4 o'clock with our overnight ratings. And we were seeing a lot of fragmentation through the years. This is nothing new, not just on linear, across all platforms. So we knew that we had to figure out a way how to connect in marketing, in our marketing division, how to connect all the data, because there's so much data that Univision has. If we could predict viewership, that would be a game changer for us, because we would be able to have the right media mix, be able to ask for the right funding seasonality, and we would be able to continue to drive ratings for our primetime lineup.
Our greatest challenge was figuring out how much data we needed and realizing that we actually had all this data to be able to get these models up and running. We had to take a step back to move forward, and we actually had to change our models to, instead of focusing on premieres only, we were focusing on time periods. So every hour, every day, and see how our programming was behaving that way and how our viewer behavior was constantly changing hour by hour.
At the end of the day, we decided to develop a sort of crystal ball, a project that we named Bola de Cristal. And this is where we would essentially look into the crystal ball 3 months out into the future and see what the environment would be for our premieres. And this became an early warning system for the marketing organization to essentially be able to optimize our investments and our media mix.
We've sustained in very vulnerable moments where we see our competitors and general market declining. We've grown. We have brought in younger viewers because we're able to predict across different audience segments. Look, we've been number one 28 years in a row. So there's actually no way that the marketing division could have stepped into the future and remained competitive if we wouldn't have developed predictive modeling. I think we would have stayed behind.